Welcome to my channel. My name's Brittany at Coslit Candle Co. and I make videos all about everything you need to run your candle business. Today I want to do a little review on Aztec Candle Tart Wax, and I wanted to do this today because I have been struggling to find a good tart wax that I really, really love, and this one's looking really promising, and if it is, I wanted to share it with the rest of you. Before we get started, I wanted to say I know I've been gone for a little while, but I am back now and I have so many surprises up my sleeve that I just want to share with you guys, and I can't wait to do that. One announcement though is I reached 1,000 subscribers and I cannot believe that happened. Honestly, I don't even know what to say. 1,000 people out there have subscribed to these videos and are watching me. That's insane, and I just want to say thank you so much. It means the world to me. I can't even describe it. So, as always, I got all of my stuff together before the video, just so you guys didn't have to watch me wrestle through the box. So I do know what it looks like, and I'm very excited to share it with you guys. So I guess we'll just jump right on in. Here's the case. It's pretty big. You can't really see it right now with the camera angle. I'm gonna switch it over, but trying to open it up for you guys. Like I said, I'll get a better angle for it. Oh, I guess I didn't get everything. But I'm just gonna tear into it. Alright, initial reaction. It does have a light smell to it. A light smell, but I'm sure with fragrance oil, it's gonna take that right off. But initial reactions, I thought it was gonna be a slap, and I'm super excited. It's not, it's in bead form. So, ooh. So, still, it's definitely melting. Let's see. Definitely firm, definitely a tart wax. But I love the feeling of it. So I'd say it's like an off-white color. Nothing too bad. Like a regular candle wax. I don't see instructions, which is fine. I did look it up beforehand. I do know some waxes come with instructions, like melt point, mix temp, all of that. But since they didn't do that, I'm going to just explain to you. Actually, maybe it's on the side of the box. No, it's not on the side. So, the melt point on this wax is 170, and the pour temperature is 140, and it says it can hold from 6 to 10% fragrance oil. I like to do it as much as I can, so I do 10% in all of my waxes. I'm a little extra like that, but if you're not, that's fine.
Alright guys, so yeah, nice color, nice packaging, nice form. I'm really digging this so far. It's gonna be easy to work with. I like this a lot so far. Okay, so we'll weigh some out. I'm gonna do 6 ounces, so we're gonna weigh some out, get some molds going, see how it works. So I'll be right back.
So that was fun. I'm really glad that I don't have to cut into it like I usually do with my other wax. It's gonna be a lot easier to handle. So I'm just gonna get everything going. I need 154 grams of wax. So I'm just gonna use a metal tin to scoop it. Okay, so 154. sticky. Not bad though. $1.55, not too bad. Leave that in there. Okay, I'm gonna put this on some heat. Let's see where it goes. It's actually melting fairly quickly. Pretty clear so far. Here, I'll show you. I don't know if you guys can see. Yeah, you can't see that. Okay, so it's heating up fairly quickly. It actually kind of smells like soy ten a little bit. Not too big of a deal though, I think. And it also says take it off the heat when you're ready to mix your fragrance oil. So get that going now. So the wax is just about ready to pour. I am going to angle my camera just so you guys can watch me pour it and make your judgments based off that. So I really think that's the best angle we're gonna get here. But it cooled fairly quickly. I don't know. And I'm just doing this to see what the wax is going to do. So it doesn't have to be perfect. Okay, so I'm gonna let this cool a little bit and I'll show you guys when it dries or when it cools what it looks like and let you know from there. Well, that took about 2.5 to 3 hours. I'm not sure why it took so long to cool. I'm not sure if it's just the type of wax or what, but it did take a while to cool. However, I do like. Still a little soft, but I figured this would be okay. Yeah, so it's pretty nice. The cold throw is definitely there. Definitely there. Which I'm excited about. I want to use this wax to make my brittles. I'd say it's definitely a good wax to use overall. I really like it so far. Today I think I'm going to end the video and the next video around I'll let you know how the hot throw is. But overall I really like this wax. It's firm. It's got a good cold throw. Like I said, it did take a long time to cool, but I'm not sure if that's something I did or if it's just the wax. But in the grand scheme of things, that's not the worst thing to have to deal with. So, yeah, that's pretty much it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I actually had a lot of fun doing it. So, if you guys want more videos like this, or if you have any ideas or questions, or anything you want to see, just let me know in the comments. I hope you guys have an amazing day, and I will see you guys next time.